Welcome to this brief guide on how to use the CHOOSEROWS formula in Excel. If you've ever been looking at a data array in Excel and thinking, I need to pull out individual rows from this particular data array, the CHOOSEROWS formula, which has just been added to Excel, is here to help. Here you can see I have my data array in Excel. This is an inventory list that's actually going to be getting updated dynamically. So I have a data array that's going to be changing and I need to reference individual rows of it. So what I can do is I can select where the cell where I'd like my choose rows to be found, and I'm going to type in choose rows, and then I need to select my array and the row numbers. So here I am going to select my array, the entire data set, and then I head back to my formula and I enter in a comma following my array, and then enter in the individual row numbers, all separated by a comma. In this instance, I want, say, rows 3, 4, 5, what else can we do? We can do 7 and 9. And then once I've selected all of my rows that I would like, I put a close parentheses, and then I can simply hit enter, and there I have my final array with all of the rows pulled directly from the table that I would like. Now, one of the benefits here is that if someone was then to go and update the inventory list here and make some changes to it, say for instance, changing the unit price of item 4 to $25 each, which will then update the inventory value to $46.50, you'll notice that it's automatically updated inside my choose rows area as well. And the benefit of this particular formula is it does work across sheets, just like all other formulas as well, so you can reference data arrays found on other worksheets. And that is the brand new CHOOSEROWS formula in Excel. I hope you found this tip extremely useful, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.